Good afternoon, everybody. Thank you for listening to me. I am N. Joy from Bishop Westcott Boys School, and I'll be teaching you today History Civics for Standard 6. Before I begin my subject, I like to tell you this marking scheme. Class 6 History Civics, the marking scheme. You should be prepared with a strategy to tackle this subject. So, to prepare your strategy, you should know the marking scheme. Now, here history, the name is history, but here the marking scheme consists history, civics and GK. History will be 40 marks. In 40 marks, there will be 4 or 5 long questions. Rest all will be objective type, like dates, terms. Please learn the terms given in the book. Books and authors will be asked. Second comes civics. This portion is little but very important, because this carries 30% of the marks. This will have, say, rural municipality will come, urban administration, local self government. In local self government, you will have 2 parts. One is urban, that is how municipality is formed, and the second one is rural, panchayati raj. And the third part is GK. GK will consist of 10 marks. This 10 marks, 8 marks will be on current GK and current affairs from the book, and also some part of school GK. A student is supposed to know the history of the school he studies in, that part also. That consists of 2 questions will come from history. Sorry, 2 questions will come from GK, school GK. Your diary consists of lot of information. Please read your diary also. This is all about the marking scheme. Now, I will go ahead with my first chapter, that is why we should study history. Why should we study? Is the study of history relevant? It is futile to study history, because history teaches us only about the past events of yesteryears. It is of no use. Why bother study history? First, you must know the worth of history, why we should study. Then it will generate interest in you. In your home, you have a photo album. The photo album consists of photographs of events in your family. You can see your grandfather's photo, father's photo, and how your parents looked like when they got married, and how you as a baby looked like, and your childhood photos. Some of the photos you don't like to show also of your childhood photos. This album speaks about the history of your family, and you get gather a lot of interest and information from this. Why? It tells you why you are present in this form. The first question which come to our mind, why bother to study history? History is seemingly futile subject, which you may think is restricted in some series and outcomes of yesteryears. Any subject matter requires justification, and hence should be worth of your attention, time and value. So, what is the justification of studying history? Being a history teacher, my first and foremost strategy is to make you aware the history, what is the importance of history. Let us understand it with an example. History of Indian cricket. Boys, you are very much interested in cricket, I know, so I have taken this illustration. Here are a few dates have great significance. In 1932 AD, India played the first match against England in 1932, before independence, and it won the match. In 1983, India won the first and the only World Series held in Australia. In 2002, India won the NatWest Series in England. In 2011, India won the second World Cup title win, first team to do so in home soil. So we know now about the history of cricket. We are a cricketing nation and you are motivated to play cricket, because you know the facts, the historical facts. We are aware that we Indians can be world class cricket batsmen. We can be famous as batsmen. It's a game which we excel. So you as a student motivated to play cricket, you want to be Rahul Dravid, you want to be Virat Kohli, all because you know the history of the Indian cricket team. That gives you confidence, motivation, and you are influenced by their performance of our Indian cricket team in this world. Thus we observe, history helps us to understand people and societies. History helps us understand change and how society we live in. The importance of history in our lives is known. In 1983, India started to believe that we can be the best in world in something, in some games. History as a contributor to moral understanding. History provides you an identity. Studying history as a symbol of good citizen. History teaches us our culture. History is a study of our past, a record of events that happened long, long ago. For example, the original citizens of Indians were the Dravidians, and Tamil was their main language. Aryans came from Southeast Asia, occupied the northern India. We learn all this from the Sangama literature. The history of our country, how the Aryans came, who are the Dravidians and who are the Mongoloid class. The word history comes from the ancient word histo. The word history comes from the ancient word histo, which means know this. People who study and write history are known as historians. Okay. Now, I am coming to your textbook portion, the first chapter here. It's an introductory chapter of history. What is history? Relevance of history. History study the past to learn how our forefathers lived. History is a link between the past and the present. History tells us about the kings, queens, and the common people. We learn about the achievements of great men, how they changed the people's lives and influence not only them but the future generation. We know the presidents of various countries who have changed the history of the country. It answers questions about the past. History helps us to understand our society in India. History teaches us about our culture. By culture, we mean art of living, architecture, sculpture, literature, religious and languages. Culture also includes how we dress, how and what we eat, what rituals or festivals we celebrate, our amusements and the values we cherish. History tells us so many things, what we are, why India is like this today, how the British ruled over India, how our Indian economy was stagnant during British period, how English education came to India, the Mughals ruled over India, and how it lived the common lives. For example, you will be surprised to know that some historians write that the chicken was discovered by the people of Mohenjo-daro and Indus Valley civilization. History helps us to know our past mistakes. History teaches us our past mistakes so that we do not repeat them. It teaches us to remain united and be proud of our culture. History tells us, teaches one thing, we all Indians must stand united, or else again British will come and rule over us. Irrespective of caste, culture, religion, we have to stand united, and then only a country can prosper and self-rule can exist. Now I am coming to the two parts, the history and prehistory.